Oh, hello, you bunch of weirdos, and welcome to my personal top 10 players that I used in FIFA Career Mode in 2015. That means I'm going to be going back and taking players that I used in Career Modes in FIFA 15 as well as FIFA 16. And the way that I rank these players isn't by the rating or the statistics, but just how much I had fun playing with these players or they just endeared themselves to me. So that isn't really a scientific way to rate them, but it's my list. So if you don't like it, you can go ahead, hit that dislike button down there. But please actually leave a like. I have low self-esteem. So who made my top 10? Well, you're going to find out right now at number 10. Oh, you knew this guy was going to be on the list, but a little bit early, you guys might be saying. The channel mascot, Mr. Victor the Pirate. Oh, I am Barbo. Look at this absolute pacey run. And this is just a great example of what a Barbo going to do for you. Even though his finishing isn't even that great, he's still going to finish because he's got no fucks to give and just absolute the strength, the pace, the combination, and the name. He's a pirate. He's gonna take what he wants, and you gotta play the pirate music as he just absolutely abuses everybody. And even when he's not scoring, he causes so much freaking chaos that absolute wonder goals happen like this trickler. Oh, this absolute trickling gem up against Man City. Oh, Caballero, you're gonna have better days at the office than that, my son. And this is a list of players that I love to use, and I freaking loved using a Barbo, and scoring with him was just absolutely angelic every single time. So that is why Mr. Freaking Barbo doing a little bit of the skill run right here. Look at this heel to heel flick, and then he's gonna go five hole through the defender and absolute finish him right there. And that's why he is at number 10. At number 9. Now I'm gonna get a little controversial here. I'm putting Jackie Butland at freaking number 9. You might be saying, how did you have fun with a keeper if you're never using him? Well, I would say this. I had a lot of enjoyment just watching Jack Butland be an absolute freaking brick wall up against pretty much everyone in the sexy, sexy Soka Luna. Look at this. You guys have seen it. My defense is just absolute shit sometimes, and Jackie Butts just absolutely bailed me out time after time after time, and I think we had the most number of clean sheets in both of the seasons that we've gone against one of the best defensive records of any teams. I think he might be even better than the Pokemon career, but he was just absolutely scintillating. And that's why he makes it at number 9, Mr. Jackie Butts. At 8. We're gonna take you back to the Parma Death Curry Road, and this was my MVP, Mr. Lodi, about to go explodey. Look at that 5-hole, and then just rifles it into the back of the net. This man's got old man game. He was absolutely prehistoric when we got it, but he was just making some amazing, amazing plays, man. Not only could he put it into the back of the net, he was... I don't know. How do I put this? He was the best free kick taker I've ever used in any FIFA, period. Like, look at this! Absolutely, Jesus! Look at the angle, look at the inch perfectness of some of these free kicks, and not only did he have 88 free kick, you know, accuracy and the free kick specialist, I later in this career mode got Pirlo and traded him in for Lodi, and I liked Lodi better because I think every single freaking shot that I took with Lodi actually went into the net, including this absolute beauty. Oh, my personal favorite, Mr. Old Man Game himself, Lodi Explodey, is number 8. At 7, we go into Luton Town, Vikings and Pirates crew mode, and this guy is making it to number 7 because he can do things like this. And you might be asking, who is that? Who was that? Bale? Was that freaking Eden Hazard? No! That is a 64 rated left back named Kim Soo Beam, aka the Korean Laser Beam, who lived up to his name, not because he could just put in bangers from distance from this, but he could actually, he was our best free kick taker over the course of the freaking series. Look at this absolute banging stuff, and you might not be believing me. It's like, you must have had sliders on. There's no way this guy is 64. Look at this. Just look at this. His long shots are 56, his finishing is 43, his shot power is 55, and his free kick accuracy is 62, and he's putting in absolute bangers like this. A fan favorite, my personal favorite MVP from the Luton Town career mode, Kim Soo Beam, a Korean laser beam. At 6. I'm gonna say it right here, I made a mistake. I made an absolute horrible mistake at the start of the Soka Luna career mode because I almost sold freaking Arnautovic, and I'm wrong. I'll admit it, I'm a man. I was wrong because Arnautovic is absolutely golden. Him, with the combination of him and Shaqiri, is just absolutely unstoppable at times. He gets bags of goals, assists, and another thing that I absolutely love about him, he could do it all, is his free kicks. Look at this. He does the long Cristiano Ronaldo run-up, and if you have that animation in this game, your free kicks just seem to go in a lot higher. I've had people, you know, Wesley Sneijder and all these other guys on the team, and they can't even compare. Arnautovic is just my boy, and he's endeared himself to my heart, and that's why he's number six.
That's five.
There's a category five. Hurricane pulling into town. Mr. Lord Redeemer himself. Hurricane going chip life right there. He played for us in both the Pokemon Career Mode and the Luton Town Career Mode, and he was absolute. The Hurricane Azard was absolute a monster and crucial to us in the Pokemon Career Mode, but I am showing you what he is doing in the Luton Town Career Mode, which he was only there for half a season, but when he was there, oh, his time there was, oh, oh, so sweet. Look at this absolute 43-yard banger from out in the distance. And man, oh man, oh man, that is why he is going to go ahead and endear himself at the number five position as we see that beautiful, beautiful yellow watermelon trickling, twirling through the air at four. The man at number four could easily be number one. I think anybody who's ever bought and used Paw Pogba knows that He's the bee's knees. I mean, he can do everything. He can pop up and score. He can defend. He can do free kicks. He can solve world hunger. I truly believe he could solve world hunger if he really put his mind to it. And these are just some of the clips of him scoring, but it's everything beyond that that he does so well. He's so good at suffocating in the midfield and distributing the ball. I wish I could find more examples for it, but honestly, you guys already know how good Paw Pogba is, and that's why he's at number four. Three. Sometimes players just play above their rating and endear themselves to your hearts when they score crucial goals, and that is why Mr. Timo Werner, aka Timo Wiener, aka Give Him the Wiener, from my Borussia Dortmund career mode. I think he's 72 rated, but he played better than Royce. He played better than Aubameyang. He played better than Paco Alcazar and Dybala. He was my favorite striker that I used almost the whole entire of FIFA 15. He was an absolute beast, and he just played beyond his abilities. And you know one guy who's really popular that agreed with me? That is Mr. Flickify. Go ahead and ask him about Timo Werner. I had a massive struggle on who to put at number one and number two, but I had to settle on it. Ahmed Musa coming in at number two, aka the best player that I used in FIFA 15, aka the guy who can break career mode. This man was absolutely broken in FIFA 15. His combination of not just, everyone knows he's a pace monster. You can see it right here. He had 90 plus pace, 90 acceleration, but it was 90 stamina, and then his high agility, as well as ball control and dribbling, made him just, it broke the game. Not only is he gonna get a whole bunch of opportunities, you know, breaking in on goal, he could stop, he could pop, and he would just provide three or four more chances for you every single game. And for that, he had to be the best player in FIFA 15. And at number one, who is my favorite player that I used in FIFA in the year of 2015? When you go ahead and you name an episode Shaqiri Goes God Mode, I think it's pretty much decided that you have determined that this player right here was the best player that you used in FIFA Career Mode for all of 2015. The man was so strong, so agile, so precise, so technical. He could provide, he could score goals. He, even when he wasn't scoring goals, he was unstoppable. You had to take him down. He earned so many freaking penalties for me. And if you didn't take him down, he was pretty much just going to absolutely abuse you, man. And then when he just felt like it, when he felt like he was going to score, he was just going to go and do it. And there was nothing you could do about it. He could go far post. He could go near post. He could shrug you off. And it was that combination of strength plus agility. And his finishing is not even that good, but it felt like if I had a good shot, I was going to take it and I was going to bury it 9 times out of 10. And that's why he is my number one for 2015. So yeah, that was my top 10 players that I used in Career Mode in 2015. Hopefully you guys did enjoy. Do you disagree with me? Tell me in the comments down below who were your top 10 players that you used in Career Mode this past year. Hopefully you guys had an amazing 2015. Here's looking at 2016 and bigger and better things coming for the channel. We got the freaking Manchester United Career Mode coming at you real soon, as well as more Pokemon, maybe some Star Wars, even some sexy Stokalunas. So I cannot wait. 2016 is going to be the best year for me on YouTube. I can already feel it right now. And by this time next year, I'm hoping maybe we can hit 10,000 subscribers. We'll see. We'll check back in a year and see if I've hit that goal. Come on, guys. Throw up the hashtag Road to 10K. Let's go ahead. Let's get there, guys. And yeah, that's pretty much it from me, B-Mus. Hopefully you guys have an amazing New Year's. And guys, you know the motto already. Remember to stay humble, stay yourself, and be weird.